for a second. Alright, welcome fellow castigators to another glorious episode of Gas Mask Gamers. As always, I'm here with Jensen. I'm here with GamerMike. And we're going to talk about some stuff that probably won't be all that cool.
Hey,
don't do it! You stop that! You don't do it!
Oh!
Don't do it! I see what you're doing. Don't you dare. And I kicked off this platform so fast. Oh my gosh. Hey! You watch that.
Wait, what's it? I forget the spelling.
You misspelled it. He ruined it. Nice.
Nigerian.
Anyway. Hey. I better start this game. Oh my goodness. You cut that out.
I put the T in. Can't say the F word.
Better watch yourself, boy.
Hold.
All right.
A hard F.
So you guys remember the shooting in Tennessee? Right, the Christian school shooting in Tennessee.
Yeah, with the
trans
psycho
shooter,
woman,
Audrey Hale. She had a manifesto, and we've been spending the last few weeks just waiting for this stupid thing to be released, and the police keep talking about it and how it's being reviewed and all this different crap. Well. Very interestingly, this place is burning up fast. Covenant School filed a motion to block the release of Audrey Hale's manifesto due to alleged security concerns in the document. They are claiming
that's odd.
Yeah. It sure is. Pretty concerning, actually. They are claiming that if it was released, it would compromise, like, the security of the school in some way. Persons in the school, staff, or, you know, etc. Now, this could be true.
Reload.
Could be. But we have a right to be suspicious.
Wow.
Since we just love to do a little theorizing, of course we could question whether any of that actually has to do with the FBI, who made it pretty obvious that they did not want to release it at all. Reload. And we're trying to block the whole thing, which many people reasonably posited was a obstruction of justice. I don't know if it actually is legally, but in theory, yeah, I would say that is. I personally think it should be released. Because if there's a security thing about the building, then it's probably something that you can change. If it's about a person, well, I mean, that's
tough. You can redact it.
Yeah, and you can redact thing if there's something like some kind of personal information of someone involved.
Yeah.
Someone's person.
Or like someone's address or something.
Right. So yeah, just to, I mean, of course, this doesn't mean that it won't get released. This is just what they're asking for.
Well,
but it's kind
of, I don't know,
it's weird.
If it was like applied equally, like the, because I don't really like glorifying or like getting them celebrity status, all the shooters and, you know, mass murderers. Like, that's what they want. So on one hand, it's like, yeah, don't tell the general public their name, don't share their writings and stuff. But if you're going to share the writings and share the name for almost all the shooters in Mass Murders, then why not this shooter in Mass Murderer?
Right.
Like, that's just unequally applied.
Yeah, no, I
a little bit odd.
I agree. We'll see what happens with it, but you know, I thought it was just a little bit suspicious. Just a little bit.
Kind of sus.
Maybe because it goes against the agenda. Oh, maybe.
Yeah. I mean, I don't care whose agenda it goes against.
I want to see it.
Yeah.
Everyone needs to know.
Well, I mean, not just because I want to see it on a personal level, but...
I want to know.
I feel like rightfully... It should be public.
Yeah, I would like to see the inside of the mindset of the crazy chick so we can, like, understand the motives more.
Yeah, you know. And I think it's good for people to see so that, like, A, they know how to recognize, you know, someone who could be a potential shooter. Or B, if you're a potential shooter with the same thoughts, you can recognize that your little plan is not going to work.
Yeah, you'd be like, oh, that's me.
So I feel like if we're not going to have, like, so I feel like if you're not going to have, like, public hangings and that sort of thing, then you at least have to, you know, have the manifesto public and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Can't just be a private thing because you said so.
Yeah, I mean, it's just applied unequally. That's the real... kind of weird thing, or like unjustified thing, I guess.
Uh oh.
Damn it. Oh, hello. Release all the other shooters' manifestos, not this one. It's like, why?
They be proud of their people. Yep. Got to do it to him. Had to do it to him.
Maybe because it was... Maybe because it, you know, shine a light on the mental illness and the psycho lifestyle.
Yeah. I think it would be interesting if all the thoughts on it are... You know, anywhere near... the people who we regularly accuse of being... mentally ill.
Yeah.
I don't want to say I'm on the level of a licensed psychologist or anything, but it's nice to have vindication for this sort of thing, you know?
I see a pattern.
Yeah.
Bitch.
Because most people be like, oh, you don't have a mental illness. You're just in the wrong body and whatnot.
You are.
And we're like, no, it is a mental illness, and it'd be nice to have, like, something to always point to. I mean, we can either way. It's still a trans, you know, one of, like, five transgender mass shooters. But, I don't know. The more the better, I think. If that makes sense at all.
Okay, maybe not. Put it like that, but yeah.
Well, I don't mean the more shooters. I meant like the more information. Oh my god.
Okay.
Yeah, that was not what I meant at all.
The more transgender shooters.
The more transgender shooters, the better. Come on, bring on the mass shooting.
I mean.
Let's go.
That's
just terrible.
Yeah. More information out there in the public. More terror. I get it. It makes sense.
Yeah, if those tyrants from
Iraq or Afghanistan or whatever the fuck you're from. You know what I'm talking about, right? Just tell them, stop coming here to do terrorist acts, because we have those here. They're called trans. Oh, we got enough.
It was like, we're full, okay,
we're full. We got
all filled up on terrorists.
What?
I said we're all filled up on terrorists.
We're all filled up on terrorists, all right? Just go somewhere else. There is a whole world that you can terrorize.
Now we that's a deterrent.
It's not me, it's you.
Oh gosh, here comes the tank.
Oh wait, no, it's not you. It's
oh
me.
Lord. No, it's definitely them. What the rocks doing though?
What are the rocks doing though?
Topic system.
Oh my
god.
We'll
let you guys know. You guys can come over here.
Burn! Grandma, burn!
Oh, I'm
getting
beat up!
With real balls. And not colored hair.
Not them fake balls.
Damn it.
Them fake balls. We want our chairs to have real balls. So when you shoot them, they.
I'm gonna get a copyright strike. I accidentally put on a mod that has music. Yeah, this is terrible.
What is it?
Oh no.
It makes the tank the Giga Chad meme. Like the guy with the beard and the big chin. Damn it. I fell. That's embarrassing. I'm gonna have to disable that real quick.
Somebody help me.
After the match.
Yeah, usually it doesn't.
Oh no.
Yeah, it didn't say.
Copyright strike.
Ammo here.
At least for social media platforms anyway. Almost you started at the beginning of the song, it's harder for them to tell.
Yeah. Ah! Oh. Ready? Alright. Nice. Don't shoot the cars. I know how you love to shoot the cars, Micah. It's like your favorite pastime, shooting cars.
I do. Whoop. Love me a good car shoot.
Yeah. Love me a good match shoot, you know what I'm saying? Watch out! Okay. Don't come at me. Don't come at me.
Don't redeem that.
I don't know. Any other thoughts on this manifesting situation?
I mean, nothing that's on.
Defend me,
hasn't already
I'm
been said. Like, it's kind of sus.
Yeah, I think the FBI needs to do their job.
Very simple. The FBI needs to do their job. I like that.
Yeah, they're like succinct, they're investigating, right? So you investigate and then you show the evidence and stuff, right? That's how that works.
Micah, that's too hard.
No, I agree. There has to be follow through.
I don't understand.
Don't shoot that car. It's funny though. I think I shot the car.
Oh no.
I think that was me.
I was pinned.
Where's our instant replay? Oh wait, I actually have it going. We'll see in a second if it was me. Yeah, it was me.
We need to analyze the footage.
Dang. So dumb. In my defense, I was trying to save him from that hunter.
Appreciate you.
Trying to be a bro.
Just me?
Now you're
going to
get killed by the board anyway.
I will heal myself.
Goodness, who's...
Can last for a bit. Hold on, y'all.
That was
I gotta
right.
Heal.
I'm a reload.
Yes.
Chainsaw here. Mm.
Let me heal you up now. This is what friends are for.
So, as a segue, I would like to ask, anyone think of any new boycotts?
The Ford gay car.
Oh, yes, perfect. Tell us about that.
A what?
My dad talked about it.
Ford's gay truck, right?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought that was gay.
To celebrate, like, pride and stuff.
Yeah, their gay truck.
It came out with a...
I didn't see the commercial. I just saw a screenshot of a truck that had, like, a pride flag wrapped around it.
Yeah, I guess they sell a paint job of one of their cars with the rainbow, like, color scheme.
Oh, I thought that was fake.
Yeah, no, that's
I don't know. My dad said it was real.
No, it's real. It's like
I heard it from
him. There's a whole commercial for it.
Guys, it's made. Next month.
Ah!
They want to get ahead of the curve.
Yeah, usually I'm... You know, impressive Ford, you know, solid vehicle. So it hurts to say, but you know, if you gotta boycott them until they apologize, then that's what has to happen, unfortunately.
Ammo up here.
Yeah. One of the guys is like, they're committing financial suicide for like.
They all do. Well, it's like. These companies are being infested by the woke people that go to college.
Yeah.
And are indoctrinated, and then they go and get jobs and push their ideology and
they're like, this is a good idea. We're gonna have so many people buy our stuff.
Things are going really badly all of a sudden.
So yeah, I saw companies advocating for woke liberal garbage, and they're like, you know what? We're gonna do that too. Yep, so don't buy any Ford anything.
I drive a Ford. I can't do that, Micah.
Walk off a cliff.
Yeah, but
okay, you
already
can't walk to work.
You already purchased that car, you're fine.
I first date. Use, but should I need got parts in the future? Maybe.
Yeah, if you're thinking about buying a Ford, don't, because Ford doesn't like you.
Just don't do it. Ford doesn't like you.
A new Ford.
They don't like your face.
You one, you're not giving Ford money.
Ah.
Use.
Also true. Right.
Get a secondhand one.
I'm healing.
Also, hey man, the founder of Ford was a Nazi sympathizer, so.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was not the best person. Kind of ironic.
Whoa, what the heck?
Oh my gosh.
Dang, another jockey?
How did you get?
He's putting me in the fire! Oh, Lord! That was awful.
Oh, we need to get to the safe room.
Oh, yep. We need to run.
I'm throwing a pipe and I'm running.
Oh, help! Crap. Well, this is going great.
You guys need my help? I just don't understand why. They're run by people who just want to make money. You know,
I'm seeing the end. I'm seeing a bright light.
Like, why do you let these people, like,
oh my liberal,
with your
I'm stuck.
Your company, you know.
Get off me. Come on, give it to me.
How have we like not realized that this woke stuff isn't actually profitable?
Yeah, I think
the people who like just are purely there to make money, not notice.
Their priority is not money. It's the
no.
Push a message of Marxism.
People who are priority to make money really run the company.
Jaeden, I saved.
He's welcome to.
Oh
my gosh.
I didn't even realize.
I'm reloading.
That
no. What were you saying, Jensen? I couldn't hear you over the zombie screaming in my ear.
I'm saying that
I need to change
the people who make the vote decisions to put a gay truck in their commercial are not the people who really run the business making money. You know?
They're like the
this is usually
board
marketing.
Like,
yeah, this is usually a marketing team.
Yeah, marketing.
I'm sure it has to get approved, but ultimately it
yeah, I mean
mostly those people just don't give a shit what you do as long as it makes money. And so I bet it was somebody convinced higher up business people that hey, if we do we'll get money or woke points. I don't know. I'm forgetting the term everybody uses. You know, we'll get a lot of money if we do this commercial. We put a gay flag on the car for Pride Month. You know, we'll get a lot of money. Then, you know, mm-hmm. if you can convince them that, they'll say yes to you. And then it gets made. That's probably what happened with the whole Dylan Mulvaney Bud Light thing. Somebody said, hey, look, everybody's talking about this guy who just celebrated 100 years of being an idiot. Hey, if we make him influencer for our product, it'll make people want to buy it.
Did you say 100 years?
The
100, not nah,
the youngins.
Yeah, I should say that. I meant like a year. A year. Yeah, he's you'll influence more young
he's
people.
He's being a little bit hyperbolic.
They're saying they probably told him, oh, you'll widen your audience that you're trying to sell your beer to. And they probably said, yeah,
so,
hey,
with
we'll...
the youth.
Yeah, yeah. They probably thought, oh, well, yeah, we'll just sell beer to more people. That's fine. And then they went ahead and did that and committed suicide. They didn't really think through the cons, and neither did the marketing department, clearly.
You guys can join me now.
I don't. It's. But, like. Alright, I'll leave, I guess. It's just such an oversight, though. Like, you know, you appeal to your consumer base. Your consumer base are not homosexuals and, like, liberal retards, right?
No.
They're
and most
blue-collar
people buy
workers.
They buy a truck as a utility vehicle to do stuff with. Put stuff
right.
in the back, all things, and that's usually not fruit.
Trannies don't do stuff.
So, they don't.
So, and they're
so
only like 1% of the population.
Exactly. So to do that and put it on a truck, just like Bud Light, is alienating your customer, the people, the main people who buy your product. And it's not going to make more money. It would make more sense if they put it on the lowest end sedan. You know, if you did that, that'd make sense because they're just trans people who don't have a lot of money because they refuse to work. So that's all they can afford is the lowest car in their lineup. So
yeah.
It would make sense to put a pride flag on the cheapest vehicle in their lineup. But no, they put it on their brand spanking new truck.
It's kind of hilarious because they're trying to market their whatever the heck they're selling to gay socialists most of the time. Like gay socialists. Like
themselves.
That is not the... Right, that is not the consumer base that you want. I'm not gonna buy anything. So stupid.
So stupid!
Yeah, what I'm saying is that there's some serious convincing on here that it'll make money. That's the whole reason why most businesses do things, right? Make a profit. And if this,
you would think
if
that,
these
but
people
I think
will make money, then they'll do it. But clearly, somebody's not.
My
thinking
opinion,
all ends, all
my
sides.
My opinion is that their priority is not money. Like most of these,
no.
most of the higher up, like
no.
In the
higher
businesses
ups,
nowadays,
no higher ups want
these
money.
These grooming kids.
That's what
and
I was talking
pushing
about with all these
gay
babies.
Socialism, right? They don't
taking
want money.
The daddy's company.
They don't. Those people don't want to make. Don't want money. I'm saying, I guess, the dad of the company, in Jaden's term, that's the guy who wants to make money. And the people who are still in those companies are probably ones who actually want to make money, but it's those nepo babies that don't. They don't care. If they can whisper the right things with trickery into certain people's ear, that's another way.
Well, from what I've seen, I think the latter is more probable than the former. I think a lot of big businesses nowadays are not. I mean, yeah, there's a little bit of both, but right now you're seeing lots and lots of companies not really care about money. Like, obviously, they can see that they're not making money from doing this, but they're still doing it. So why is that, right? So
that they can feel moral.
Right, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, so it's a moral kind of priority rather than a money priority. Yeah.
Every human wants to.
They think they're
going to
be better than everyone because they're pushing.
They'll self-sabotage. Yeah.
That's probably why you see.
We shoot this stupid
Christian-owned companies not doing this because they know the right thing to do is to not advertise them.
Can't even
way.
See this smoker. What the heck?
And they do not care what you think.
Yeah.
Of them.
Right, Christian businesses are pretty based. I would.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wow, that went well.
Well, I think I've said this before, but I'd like to go back to the greedy business days where all companies cared about was just making more money, because at least they were honest, right?
Yeah,
they weren't being deceptive about it.
Yeah.
There were downsides to that, but. You did have a better chance.
As long as it's not crony capitalism.
Good things happening. You know, I think those people are the only good things that reason good things still happen. Because, you know, you have the internet, like, tearing apart people like Chris Pratt. But then the box office numbers for every Chris Pratt movie says very differently.
Or show.
And so if you were someone trying to, you know, get feelings, you might never, you know, make Chris Pratt movies, but the money men go, okay, well, actually that has to happen. And so I think the few
Chris
of those
is
that
a
are
money maker.
Yeah, the few few of those that are left are the reason we still get anything good at all, really. So yeah, they should bring it back. And it doesn't necessarily have to be greed or you know, trying to pull the wool over the audience's eyes. It's just about, you know, serving your audience and being logical so that you can, you know, survive, have a good business, and provide for your family. You know, we don't necessarily have to bring back, like, the Hollywood Mafia.
No, Hollywood has a mafia now.
But yeah,
it's
no,
a different time. Yeah.
We have to go back to people.
It's a better,
you know, being in a position where, you know, these companies have to sink low enough that they start to prioritize the
money?
Actual consumer. And
ammo here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, make sure to bleed them dry. Don't get any money to
anybody. It's the only way they're going to wake up.
I think the mindset that they should be having is that they are not in control. Like, and that they're servants to the people. Just like what the president should be.
Yeah.
You know, just have like a mindset of, what do they want?
Accountability to...
Yeah. Your...
Yeah.
Like how the mindset
that makes sense.
Is that your customer is in control. If you don't make what they want, you don't get money, you can't provide for your family.
Yeah. Unfortunately, oh my. Unfortunately, a lot of really big companies, they only are accountable to like boards. And boards that have like stock in the company, they only really want, like, a short-term gain. So they'll do anything to get the short-term game, and then they'll just leave.
Disney.
Yeah, pretty much. So you get that feedback loop where it just deteriorates the company overall.
Dude, that Disney's board is full of people who have no balls, because it's clear that they're pissed off at the CEO, and yet they do nothing about it. It's just like, you guys like, have no balls to vote him out. Jeez.
Yeah, it's amazing that it hasn't happened yet.
Reload. You guys have to have some, have to have the balls to tell him,
come
hey,
on, guys.
Change or you're out of here, you know? That's what I'd do, honestly.
Yeah, because, I mean...
Take no bullshit.
Because, yeah, leaders who think that they're above the audience and the shareholders are exactly why Disney got where they are. Because Bob Iger and Kathleen Kennedy are both, you know, absolute maniacs who are just committed to doing whatever they want to do.
Yeah, that's how Kathleen Kennedy got into power.
Hey, ammo here.
It's actually kind of a sad story. She was a personal assistant to the producer on the guy who produces a lot of Frank Markham. She was a personal assistant to Frank Markham and sometimes Spielberg. And basically, Spielberg said it himself. Her career started when she was an assistant there, and she kept speaking up and would not shut up about giving ideas in meetings.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Typical woman.
Oh! My game crashed.
Oh!
Dang it.
Oh, Lord, I'm dying.
But basically, she married Frank Marshall, the producer, so, you know, basically, who knows, maybe she slept her way to where she is. I'm not saying she did. But she
did in the sense that she would be nobody without him.
Exactly. She married the producer.
And he did sleep with him, right?
If it wasn't for that, she'd still be a talentless nobody assistant.
And so basically at some random point, I think it was E.T., she got a producer credit. Although it was for something very, very small, and then her producer credits just kept growing and growing, and she was given more power.
Even though she was technically never really a producer, technically.
No.
She's technically always just been an assistant to her husband.
Assistant or executive producer, just very small. And now she's head of Lucasfilm. You slept your way from assistant to head of Lucasfilm, kind of.
Just like Cameron.
Slept in, like, not the dirty sense, because she's married. But
I mean, still.
I mean, it's. She didn't get to where she is because she's a strong leader or a good decision maker, like Frank Marshall.
She got where she was because she's a woman.
You know, Frank Marshall produced one of the greatest films ever made, Raiders of the Lost Ark. I mean, that's not where he...
She got where she is because of tits.
But yeah.
And she didn't age well, so he shouldn't have done it.
What you mean? She's not a...
Frank
she's
was
probably
a desperate
not a,
man.
Like, whore, but...
A desperate man.
She's yeah. still...
Might not be a whore. Might be a whore. Might not be. We'll see. But... Still.
Still.
The fact remains that, you know, nepotism.
Used her power as a woman.
Yeah, and she definitely doesn't have the experience as a producer, or enough anyway.
Smoker!
Be heading a giant company.
What the heck?
The biggest, or what was the biggest fandom in existence, which is Star Wars.
I need this.
I don't know. Do you think Star Wars is still the biggest fandom in existence, still?
I gotta heal.
I would say
it either is or it's
actually
very close. I think it's definitely losing momentum, for sure.
Oh yeah.
But it's still pretty big.
It still has notoriety. Like so many people know of it. So if it's like if that's your measurement, then yeah, Star Wars is definitely up there. But if it's like committed fan base, like currently, I would not say so.
Yeah, as far as committed goes, it's probably Lord of the Rings or something like that.
Oh, definitely, yeah. Lord of the Rings. 100% for commitment.
So it just depends.
People versus Amazon.
Measurements.
I mean, Tolkien fans versus Amazon. Tolkien fans won.
Yep.
Because they are sophisticated. Well, we are a sophisticated bunch who actually read.
Oh, Lord. Yeah.
And a good percentage of them are actually, you know, well, religious in some way. Because, you know, Tolkien has a bunch of, you know, has his Catholic beliefs in there.
His
Roman Catholic
subconscious religious inspiration.
Yeah. Inspiration in there. So most, I'd say, Tolkien fans are religious in some extent, so they definitely didn't tolerate what Amazon did and is still doing.
Yeah, you just can't mess with the fandom that will watch all 11 hours of the extended edition in one sitting.
And then hear that there's another edition that exists with even more film and yearn for it. Crazy.
They want the extended.
What did they call it? What was the name? I can't remember.
I don't.
Extended Deluxe.
But Extended Deluxe. That's right. Everybody inside.
Nice.
Alright, Jensen, we're going to need you to not be idle on this next one, because this is the one where we failed so hard we did it over and over and over again.
I have a few more bites.
It was so bad. I did it so many times at the end of one of the last streams.
We almost made it a few times.
Mm-hmm. We got it right.
I got a couple bites. Don't leave the room.
Okay. So speaking of these boycotts, you're blocking the door, so make sure you at least shoot stuff.
Ow. I'm eating as well.
So am I. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
We're eating. Eating
door.
Triplets. Oh my gosh. I'm trying to talk. There's too many zombies at the start of the match. Kind of brutal.
Reloading.
I'm gonna go in there and get ammo. So a boycott for Target has begun. I'm actually not sure how well it's going to work, you know, considering it's Target. But there does seem to be a pretty decent decent amount for it. And I think a lot of people know that the boycott isn't going to work very well, since it's, you know, probably the second biggest grocery store.
I'm being jumped.
But,
Hello?
Oh, so you are.
Bot is doing nothing.
You're like super far away from
the bot has left me.
Dude, you got killed in the break room. That's embarrassing. No time for this now.
We have to keep moving. That's because you're gay.
Anyway, but people are calling for you to at least boycott it for Pride Month, which I think is reasonable. You can put it off for a month. And Walmart exists.
What's Target doing in Pride Month?
It's not like you really need Target. Well, it's related to that. It's related.
Okay, yeah, got it. Sure. See you soon.
So.
Dude, there's two chainsaws up here.
Target is selling female swimwear that you can tuck a penis into. It's got a little pouch for that. So you can hide it better. Not well, but better. And it comes in child sizes, because of course it does.
Oh my god. Alright.
right? So that was kind of the first hit. But they've also started selling items from a brand called Abpralin. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. It's an English brand. It's, How do I spell this?
Reloading.
It's Abpralin.
Reloading.
I don't know how to pronounce the B and the P next to each other. Abpralin. Reloading. Abpralin. But anyway, so of course they specialize in LGBTQ items. And among these items are a very interesting assortment. So they have, for instance, a pin with two axes on it that says "Fight for Trans Rights."
Jeez.
Oh, you almost got jumped, boy. Oh my goodness.
I gotta heal. Don't activate the tank yet.
Then they've got one that has, it's another pin, which has skulls under a guillotine, and it says homophobic headrest.
Good lord. Damn, I need trans people. I'd never do something like that.
It's creative, at least. I'll give them that.
I guess?
Gotta reload! And then there's other pins, such as Join My Gay Cult.
What? Wait, seriously?
Yeah, seriously, I'm not kidding.
Alright, that's pretty funny. I like that one. I would buy that one.
Join My Gay Cult. Yeah, you could wear that one, ironically, for sure.
Yeah. Cult.
And then my personal favorite is a pin that says Trans Witches for Abortion. Which has got to be one of the funniest phrases in
Holy
the English language.
Crap. That is funny on like many different ways.
I know. It's funny on a number of levels. Trans women for abortion.
Witches, child sacrifice, it all goes together.
Yeah. It all goes. Fantastic. Oh! Dang, I didn't even see it. Where's that tank coming from?
Not here yet.
I'm gonna throw some
I got a violent
fire.
Throw it.
Oh, I got it! Hell yeah!
Got it!
Oh my.
I can run.
Ooh!
Oh, I'm out of ammo.
Ah!
There's also some other interesting paraphernalia, such as there's a pin that says poppers open your third eye, which is a reference to a hard drug called oh hell,
I'm being hung.
To ammo nitrates, ammo nitrates, which are typically taken, popularly taken like during sex to have a psychedelic time. Don't ask me. I don't understand myself. But anyway, it's kind of interesting, this paraphernalia. It like hits all the points. It encourages abortion, violence, drugs, all the things.
Child sacrifice.
Yeah, child sacrifice, seemingly.
I mean, that's what
and,
abortion is.
Well, yeah. You're actually right on the money, Jensen. Because they also have t-shirts, and these t-shirts say, Satan respects pronouns.
Wow, they sang every quiet part out loud.
Yep, all
of them.
and another t-shirt that says Hail Trans Demons.
What?
So among all this list is also satanic. We don't even have to accuse them of being satanic. They've told us. How cool is that? Very convenient.
So all of this stuff is in Target, or they're just affiliated with Target?
Okay, so they're just not all of it is, but most of it is.
Okay, like some of it is, maybe more of the tame stuff.
Yeah, like I know the pins are in there. I know that they don't have some of the t-shirts. And a lot of it is just your typical trans stuff, or your typical LGBTQ Pride Month stuff. But I wanted to point out the more ridiculous,
the crazier,
noteworthy
ones of the company.
Just in case the bathing suit thing wasn't enough for a Target boycott, then you can.
I only heard about the bathing suit.
Cite that as well.
That's on Earth.
So yeah, just an English guy.
Sound like Paris.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
A little terrorism.
You know. A little bit of terrorism is good for the soul.
Like the Antifa stuff.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's a lot harder to boycott like grocery stores in general because, you know, you get like food and drinks and stuff from there. But yeah, there's Walmarts and you probably should just boycott it. Just send a message.
Yeah, like I said, I would like for you to boycott until they pull the items or apologize or something. But, you know, even if you're a regular Target,
try to avoid it as best you can.
At least for Pride. Just so that they get the message.
Right. You know? This the first, man.
You can at least afford me that one, I think.
Not about the money, it's about sending a message.
Yep.
As a wise man once said, before blowing up a hospital. Oh lord! Oh lord, I'm burning! Oh! I dropped a...
Dark, I don't feel so good.
Micah, you got him?
I'm dead.
Oh.
So am I.
Rochelle just teleported into the helicopter. Okay.
Boop! Well, at least someone survived. That's the important thing.
We made it.
Right. Yeah, that was weird. She like got pulled through the map and into the helicopter.
Yay, we died.
When are we gonna get a straight month?
Yeah.
White month.
When do we get to celebrate that classic vaginal sex, huh? Penetration. Vaginal penetration.
Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Well, you could argue that Christmas season is what is a straight month because it does promote a man and a woman's child's birth, so.
No, she was a virgin.
Oh.
I mean, she didn't stay a virgin, but, you know.
Maybe it's family month,
That's
family month, baby.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah.
What the heck is happening?
Yeah, I don't know why the gays get like a whole month. This is kind of weird.
Because it's a
and like Black History Month.
Guys, why are we doing the level again?
I didn't do anything.
I didn't touch it.
You're in charge, though.
I didn't touch anything.
Look, 9/11, one day of remembrance.
I'll pull us
but
out.
Pride Month gets a whole month because it's a bigger problem. Or tragedy, whatever.
9/11.
Hey, that's not my opinion. Exactly. That's just the way it is, you know?
I just call it like I see it. The fire is spreading.
Anyone want to pick a way to go? Now, I'm just going to ignore the Black History Month part.
We need a white history
month. No. Have you seen Morgan Freeman on Black History Month?
Yeah.
It's I watched hilarious. That. It was He's pretty so base. Vague. The Love dude it. Is great.
Well, why can't it just be like History Month, you know? Because, like, so many people today, they don't know.
What do they call
like,
it?
Anything Something about history.
Points. Like, not woke points, but same
They're
thing.
They're supposed to be to go to school to be educated on it.
I'm just saying, like, if you're going to advocate for acknowledging something in, like, a month holiday type thing, why can't you just say history, not just Black history? Because I think that would be more reasonable.
I'm done with these stupid right? month holidays.
You're like,
in
like
general, because
segregating the Black people.
There's only 12 months in a year. You're going to drive people crazy with that.
Yeah, there's 1 month for every gender.
Oh my goodness. But you know what I mean? Like, they're going to oversaturate it.
Well, that's why they're having, like, a day for everything, which is also stupid. I'd be happy if they just did away with that. Go away with the whole month.
Waiting for your train.
National
oh,
month
it's...
day or national whatever month.
National kiss
day.
A cat. Woo.
Yeah, I don't care about any of it. Just get rid of it all, right? Don't care. Man, you know,
I'm just
I know
saying,
I don't now.
If we were to replace... We're gonna replace Black History Month. Why can't it just be normal History Month? That's
why can't it just be nothing?
Nothing. That's what I'm saying. Just nothing.
And because today's
change
society
education.
Needs to learn from their past.
Well, we need to change the school system.
They need
system.
To be educated.
The public school system needs a lot of reform. And
that's true.
I mean, that's a whole other topic, isn't it?
Public Education Awareness Month.
That's it right there.
Hey, I wanted that.
Watch out!
Oh, hi, Mark.
Oh my
god. Watch out.
There wouldn't be a, you know.
Those.
I think if there were heavier restrictions on what teachers could talk about and more vetting in the hiring process of teachers, then there would be a significantly smaller number of number of customers for this Pride Month paraphernalia. Not that there's a whole lot,
yeah.
But
I don't know. You had quite the list there.
No. I meant okay. A lot of customers. Kid over here.
Oh yeah, there's no way there's enough customers for all that. Even people who support that.
Yeah, because I think people are finding out that like. Their whole stupid thing about allies. You know, we gotta be allies. And wearing the pride stuff is not good.
Weapons over here. Yeah, no one thinks you're an ally if they see you wearing pride flag stuff. They're gonna be like, oh, it's just another gay person.
Yeah, everyone thinks you're gay.
Ooh.
Yeah. So yeah, not a huge audience for that stuff, but enough that somebody in the numbers group thinks that it's a good idea.
It's important.
Oh lord.
But you know, even though, oh, good job.
I can't see anything. I got boomer bile on me.
Granada!
Whoop. Oh my gosh. I ran away from one and there was another in the opposite direction. Dude, that was nuts.
I ran.
You know, even though I don't approve of any, you know, company
is all the way out there.
Partnering with these whack jobs, I still very much approve of these people having like their own business or, you know, their own Etsy page and whatnot, because, you know, quite frankly, it's good to have people wearing this stuff so you can point them out and avoid them.
I mean, well, yeah.
You're like, oh man, this person's going to be a school shooter. We'll keep an eye on them.
Yeah, if you have a pin that says, I'm a terrorist, domestic terrorist, you know, you'll know. It's nice.
Well, I mean, I don't mind if they sell the stuff per se, because it does identify the whack jobs, whatever, and the businesses that support them also will know. But I draw a line where it's like, you can't advocate for, like, violence. Like, you can't incite violence on,
yeah, no.
Like a shirt or something. Like, we have laws against that, so. Like, I don't know. Execute any Nazis you see or something.
It's okay. What's that called, Michael? Do you know?
What?
What that's called? It's some sort of, like, public indecency law or something, right? Like, what's the... What are the rules exactly?
Well, there's incitement. There's incitement to violence laws, which is like verbal, like directing people to act upon somebody, like directly. And there's called, what's it called? Oh. I'm trying to think. Is it indecent? No, it's not indecency.
Indecency is nudity.
Yeah, but it's along those lines.
Yeah.
It's like verbal something. It's like you being vile or something. With your words.
Interesting. Yeah.
Hennessy? Oh. Oh, what's it? It's on the tip of my tongue! Oh!
Oh no, bro.
That's Siri.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hassy. Hennin.
I'm not sure.
See. Yes, totally Hennessy. That's what it is.
Yep. But yeah, it's
think you can hear heresy?
It's an English brand. So I think that's how it got started.
English brand.
What?
Was that they sell that stuff in. Is the brand started in England? So.
Oh yeah.
If any of the more taboo stuff gets sold in America, I hope.
Heinous.
It'll be.
No. What?
Thrown down. I don't know what you're trying to say, buddy.
It's like you just like it's not public indecency. It's like verbal indecency, and it's called like heinous or something.
Jensen, they're down.
Laws. We had that on the books.
No, you're not. You okay?
I didn't say I'm. I said there.
Oh, I heard I'm down.
Oh, sorry. Just throw you on the ground there.
Oh my.
It's kind of funny though.
I'm a snipper rifle.
Micah, heal up so we could start this other thing. But yeah, fun to see the true agendas of the transgenders. Like we go, boy, it's demons, it's Satan, and you sound like, you know, a crazy country preacher, but then they openly admit it and tote that stuff. It's like, oh, okay. There's some evidence for those accusations.
Now we know.
Interesting. Very interesting.
What is lifting this crate doing?
I think it was in our way, maybe? Pressing E next to the door, it's not happening. I just shot.
Oh, it's gonna drop the thing on that door, so I get away from it. It's the only way she's gonna die.
Kill her.
Stop it.
Hey, that was epic. Teamwork. Wait, what?
That guy peeked on you. Oh, he got me too.
This is nice. What kind of sick is this? I was just shooting human-looking shapes in the room, so he was standing right in front of me. Why?
Ammo here.
Damn, I got the noise.
Oh, drop the flashlight.
I hear a witch.
I got it.
Oh Lord.
It's Micah's time to shine. You know how he loves to shoot the witch.
My gosh, where is it?
Reloading. Where's what?
The smoker. I couldn't see it.
Yeah, they hide really well on these forest levels.
Obscenity! That's what it was!
Obscenity?
It was, public obscenities.
Obscenities.
I'm pretty sure.
Obscenities. It's obscenities.
It may fall on.
Yeah,
that.
They. Back in the day.
I would like to see.
Back in the day.
Right now, that just.
They had laws. They had obscenity laws, so you couldn't say. Like certain things in public.
Doesn't Florida have those now?
Obscenities.
People from dressing like prostitutes in public.
Well, that's indecency.
Maybe.
That's indecency.
But yeah, that's indecency. Obscenity is verbal.
Okay.
Yes. Obscenities.
Obscenities. These. Yeah.
Indecency.
So,
is
if you have like.
Right.
So if you have like written things on your shirt or emblems or something, that
those
like directly
are, yes,
incite violence or whatever.
Obscenities. You have some obscenities on your
shirt. Right, you can consider those obscenities.
Yep.
Yeah. So
I would say follow under Florida's laws that they recently passed.
Right.
So which ones do you think
so if
qualify
you're...
more? Join my gay cult or trans witches for abortion?
I guess abortion, because you're openly admitting that you have you're abortion. In a gay cult.
I don't know. I was joking. I
guess,
it's obviously
being in a gay cult.
It's obviously the ones calling for violence. Like,
I think being in a gay cult is pretty obscene, though.
Gay.
It is, in fact, pretty gay.
Yeah, but the homophobes go here under the guillotine thing. That's like,
yeah. Homophobic head
could be, yeah.
Reloading. Yeah, that's pretty borderline.
It's probably not It's probably not prosecutable because it's very lenient. A lot of the speech laws, which is good, but if you're going that far, I think that socially or culturally, you should be shunned. In my opinion.
Yeah. No, definitely. Especially the Satan ones. I actually,
dang it, I have one health.
Part of the article I have,
I get you.
Actually has, the...
What if you heal me?
Graphic designer talking about... Cover me! I'm healing! Has the graphic designer talking about how, the Satanism thing. Everyone inside! And, you know, just like a normal, you know, Satanist, he believes in the rest, which is God and all this different stuff. And it's like, okay, but if you believe in that, then why in the world would you side with Satan? If you believe in God and hell and all that, then what are you doing?
Satan!
Because Satan says be gay.
I mean,
that's why.
I mean, you literally can't
The demons rebelled, so...
I mean, you literally can't defeat an all powerful being. Like it's in, you know, he's omnipotent. It's all there. It's in the name. He's God. What are you gonna do? Aw, you know, you're so cute with your little rebellion.
Well, one third of the angels,
your little gays,
thought that you know, thought the same. So
yeah, and it was stupid. You got thrown down, kicked out.
I mean, it was futile, but you know, such is life.
Well, I'm just saying, you know.
A shotgun.
Gotta be a special kind of mentally handicapped. To be like, sure.
Well,
I'll accept my
special level of hell. They want to be in control of their own destiny. They want to be their own gods, so that's what it comes down to.
Well, you aren't. Because, you know, unlike...
I mean, in a way they are, because they decide their own destruction. Right?
Not really, because it's... It's a, you know, it's an eternal death, and unlike in popular media, Satan is not the king of hell. That's God. God is the king of heaven and hell. So either way, you're going to have to answer to him. Either way, your fate is, you know, you're going to be judged by God, and your fate is going to be decided by him. Grabbing a machine gun. So you might as well have a good time, you know what I'm saying? Like... You might as well go to the good place.
Yeah, well, there's a couple different arguments from other perspectives. But, you know, I do agree with you. Like, it is pretty dumb decision. But also, I understand why some people do decide that, because it's it is a decision. So they want to make their own decision to be selfish with their lives and
try to
be in control of their destiny.
I understand that people need, feel the need for control, and I understand that they want to do what they want to do. I mean, every human has that one. Every human wants to do whatever they want.
So,
but you ready to roll? You know, Satanism is not gonna afford you that. Cause sure, it's a choice, but it's a choice either way.
What is this?
Get my back. Why choose wrong? Do you know what direction we're going in?
We're going the right way.
I don't need health.
We're going to the lighthouse.
You see these?
Into the light.
Lemon's bottom.
I'm not feeling too
We got hard. Weapons over here.
Have you ever met any Satanists, Micah? You know any?
Not personally, no.
No one that I knew was a Satanist.
Someone should go up there, start it, and then run down here.
Secretly, somebody was a Satanist.
Oh, I guess you're volunteering, Jensen. Thank you very much.
What? Why are we running back down there?
Isn't that where the boat appears?
Yeah, but it turns off halfway, and you gotta refill it with fuel.
Damn it. Alright.
So it's better to go to the top of the White House.
Of course. They think of everything.
Oh, dang developers.
You should do community theater. That's where you meet them.
Oh.
They're all there.
I mean,
all the weirdos are the ones performing Shakespeare.
Satan!
Yeah, I've met a few gay people, so I guess they're pretty close to Satanists.
There's gotta be something wrong with you. To perform Shakespeare.
You don't like Shakespeare?
No, I do. I've been in multiple Shakespeare. But the thing is that most of these people think that, you know, he's like this legendary writer. And you know what? Shakespeare wasn't. He just wasn't. Okay, because a lot of this stuff just sounds good to us in the modern age because it has the comparatively flowery sounding language of the time. And a lot of it is actually pretty stupid and immature. Like, he just goes all in with the sex jokes, just all the time. So he did write some, like, don't get me wrong, he wrote some poetic stuff that was pretty good. He wrote some pretty witty dialogue. But you compare him to, say, you know, Robin Williams, it's not all that different.
I'm trying to get to you guys.
I'm being eaten.
You know what I'm saying?
Watch my back. Yeah. He's not,
you know, like
down the tank.
He's over whatever it's called.
Overhyped.
Overhyped,
sure. Like, I think people should still have to study them because you understand a lot about history and a lot of other things.
You can be smart.
When you do that. But I'm just saying he's not. Compared to some other writers I could name, he's not all that different. You know, like he was brilliant, but he wasn't like superhuman. You know what I'm saying? People act like he's just so untouchable.
He's God incarnate.
But if you understand what they're saying, then pretty much anyone who can understand it knows differently.
Got it.
I don't know. It doesn't really matter. I would like to stress how little it matters. Thank you. Enjoy your Shakespeare. But anyway, it just when community theaters perform it, it just attracts really weird people who do it because they want to feel smart and look smart with all of the flowery language, when in reality it's
self-important idiots.
When in reality it's not, you know. It's good fiction, but it's not. It's not actually, like, super smart. Speaking of super smart, I just lit myself on fire. So that was great. Damn it. So yeah, I mean, theater in general attracts a lot of narcissistic weirdos, but when you throw Shakespeare in there, it tends to get pretty weird up in there. I feel like it attracts the wrong sort of person. So I met a lot of nice people who understood the material, but also a lot of just terribly, terribly insufferable people.
Me. I got the last one.
Jensen got a little taste of it one time.
Of what time? What?
The first time I did it, you were there for some of it.
Oh, the Romeo
and Juliet
thing?
Yeah, you got a little taste of the insufferable hedonists.
Oh, yeah. They were, something.
That's one way.
There are a few arguments you just stayed out of, like that Jewish lesbian or lesbian who just claimed to be Jewish. Let's face it.
Jewish lesbian.
Claimed to be Jewish, but she was like the whitest white lesbian I've ever seen.
She had the nose. She was half Jewish biologically.
Look at my nose.
But as far as religion and creed, she definitely was not.
Well, there's Jewish, there's religiously Jewish, and then there's also genetically Jewish. So
yeah,
there's three really separate three.
Well, that's why I clarified.
Used it as a shield, basically. But anyway, yeah.
Yeah, she did. She used it as a shield.
Excuse me,
but
you.
Basically, she was so freaking radical. There were some arguments.
Excuse
that she
me, I'm Jewish, so I know all about oppression.
Like there was some argument someone was having about, you know, gender difference between sex and gender. And it was like one of them was what was between your legs. You know, I just stayed out of that because she was just so screaming radical that I'm like, holy crap!
Amazingly, this was before the pandemic, by the way. This was like 2018.
Yeah. And I was 18, so if I dared to argue back, I would have just been screamed at as an insolent child.
Hey, she liked to use that one too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Even though, you know, I was 18. I technically wasn't. I was really an adult. Come on, help me.
I'm an adult.
I'm trying. Okay, so I get it. But yeah, she would like overhear things and like say things to like specifically set people off.
Guys, you can jump off the cliff.
I'm not trying to, Zoe keeps trying to kill herself.
Help.
Oh my god.
So she was like an instigator.
She would literally walk walk into a room, like start of rehearsals. This is her showing up in the building, and she would be like, "Gender is a social construct."
No one cares, whore.
That's what we were thinking.
Oh my gosh, you're still alive? Holy crap.
Get to the boat!
Do you want me to come get you?
Get to the boat! Don't care about anybody. No,
leave me.
I'm leaving.
I don't know how you got down there, but... Bravo.
They're definitely instigators, just cause...
Yeah, go to the theater people, or worse.
And she would...
Community theater, yeah, you'll meet
She would people. Even say it with, like, her nose up in the air. Like a cartoon character. Like, just so self-important. So insufferable. And they just crawl all over the
Someone should
stuff.
Have... Someone should have just, a little bit of slap-slap, you know what I'm saying?
A little backhand? Boy, was I tempted a few times.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But again, we were 18... And these are condescending people who view us as children, so...
How old was she?
That wouldn't have ended well. I don't know. 40s. Almost... Yeah, middle-aged. Sad.
She was...
mid to late 40s.
So, yeah,
40 years old?
You know...
Arguing with... Okay.
You're young, you look younger than your age, so if you argued back, you're a punk kid.
She was bullying teens about
here,
oppression.
You know what you're talking about. Yeah, you couldn't argue back because, you know, they'd kick you out. I mean, I wasn't worried about being kicked out. I just didn't give a fuck.
You have no authority over me.
I didn't
You have no power yet.
Never again. Never again.
Never again.
No.
Oh, that's so funny.
I didn't even want to be part of that.
Gosh, that woman was loud.
Yeah.
So loud.
Hey, yeah, she wasn't the only one, but yeah. Arguments, those people, holy crap. I don't know what it is with those theater people. Why they're so radical.
It was funny. She was playing Juliet's mom, who is a very, like, I guess no one's technically evil in Romeo and Juliet, but kind of borderlines on evil. Like, she's aggressive, domineering, controlling. And so she was just...
She's like, I got this one.
She was just playing herself. It was really funny. She thought she was so good, but it was like, come on.
Hey, we already did this level.
You
ain't coming
back. Yeah, we started over. Station at the mall. Good
enough for me. Grab a weapon. Oh, did you increase the difficulty?
No.
We can.
You have to.
Well, we already started.
Dude, we haven't started. Quit.
Oh my gosh.
No. Quit.
Alright.
Yo, coach, kill the black man.
Well, he's white on my screen. It's Wesker.
Oh! You whitewashed him. Alright, we're going to advanced, ladies.
Well, Wesker in the TV show is black, actually, right?
That's right, yeah, he is. But they did a bad job with his outfit, and he just looked exactly like Blade. It was fucking hilarious.
Like, almost exactly like Blade.
They blackwashed him.
Reddick, too, which is sad, because I don't want to hate that guy. He's a great actor.
That was literally one of the worst TV shows I've ever seen in my entire life. That was really something.
I think Capcom needs to be more particular on who they let adapt their games.
What are you talking about?
Yep.
When the hell was that? Resident Evil movies have always been shit.
Damn it, Nick, you killed him.
There isn't a good one.
Yeah, that's true.
Hey,
let's move
on.
I could make a good one. If I had directing skills, I could make a good
one. I could make a good one.
If I had the skills.
I got the skills. I could make a good one. I could do it. I would love to adapt the first game. That'd be fantastic.
All right, YouTube listening.
That would be
YouTube
a great
movie.
Right. The first game.
Yeah, yeah.
Strong narrative. Come on.
Wait, what? So, what difficulty was
five,
this
and
on?
They all got great.
This is advanced.
Honestly.
So it's just a tier above the highest difficulty.
That chopper looks like it's heading to the evac center at the
mall. But so am
I. Working our way up.
It didn't really show me the...
Yeah, I've only played Resident Evil 1, 4, and 5, and they all have enough material to be a movie each.
Yeah.
I haven't played 2 and 3 because I want to play the originals on the PlayStation first, and then maybe play the remakes.
2 definitely does. 3, it's more like half a movie worth of material, but... Still, you could, like, merge that story with another one and have a whole movie easy. So, yeah, the games definitely line up to make it for a good movie series. It's not rocket science.
Mm-hmm.
So it's funny that they've always deviated so much.
Yeah, there wasn't really any
association
with the games to the movie.
Because, I mean, they've always been, like, with the first game, was designed specifically to look like and be structured as an American action movie.
I'd argue most of the games are that way.
Well, yeah.
Maybe not 4.
A lot of them followed suit. Yeah, maybe not 4.
5 total.
Yeah, 5 definitely. But, and even the story is structured that way. You know, like, with the boss fight at the end of everything, it should be like a slam dunk of a movie.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah,
because it's structured
like
a movie.
Horror film. But yeah, like, yeah, you have the American action movie theme. Why not run with it?
Like, when it comes to books and video games, they usually, like, are better as TV shows, but with Resident Evil... It's like perfectly suited to be films.
Honestly, if I were to remake them, I would use the Japanese title of Biohazard. I would not use Resident Evil.
I agree, Biohazard, but I don't think it would ever happen just because it wouldn't sell as well.
No, because stupid people wouldn't know what it is.
Exactly, stupid people.
Biohazard
wouldn't get
is way better of a title.
Yeah, it's better of a title and it makes more sense. I agree.
But Resident Evil's iconic, man.
Oh, shit.
Well, it's like we're saying, it would never happen because people wouldn't know what the movie was.
Yeah, it's well known as Resident Evil.
I can't
but
see.
Compromise.
In Japan, we call it Biohazard.
Right. For the Japan release, you call it that. Definitely.
Ooh, what about you just call it Resident Evil Biohazard?
That's the name of the seventh game.
Huh?
So, wait, does that mean in Japan it's Biohazard?
I actually don't know. Maybe it's Biohazard Resident Evil.
Biohazard 7 Resident Evil.
Oh!
Yeah, maybe it's just swapped.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, that was like the one game where Resident Evil, the title, actually made sense. Because it's actually in someone's house and it's the family in the house that's infected.
Resident Evil.
They made it work, finally.
Dude, I'm gonna get pulled out of window. Yep. Hurry up.
I like how we only have secondary weapons.
Yeah, it's for this level specifically.
This is a great start. I'm enjoying this. I like the thwack. I like a good thwacking.
Wacky quack.
Wacky quack. Yeah, why didn't Biohazard take, like, a note from Silent Hill's book and literally just adapt the game?
Jensen, there's pills right here, bro.
What?
Bro, there's pills, man.
Where are the pills?
Pills. Pills right here, man.
Sick.
What a...
Because, yeah, Resident Evil and Resident Evil Revelations is just them adapting Resident Evil... Not Resident Evil, I'm sorry. Silent Hill 1 and Silent Hill... Revelations is just
well,
Silent Hill 1 and 3
I think
adapted
it's because,
it.
Like...
and it worked. Why didn't they do that?
Well, I think it's because the director is an idiot. The first one, Paul W.S. Anderson, I think, is his screen credit. He's an absolute idiot who doesn't care much. But I think it still made money because, you know, Mila Jovovich is so hot, and she was popular at the time. And so they went, oh, they, like, didn't get the star power thing, and they're like, oh, this made money because of everything, and then they just never stopped making them that way. And they got progressively worse. But they've always made money because she gets progressively more naked in each one. Like, seriously.
Exactly.
There are
equilibrium.
Like, there's tons of nude scenes in all those movies. And they show more progressively.
Are you still talking about Resident Evil?
Yes. Because I've seen all but the last one. The sixth one.
I don't recall her being nude.
Yeah, she's naked in like all of them. Maybe not the third one. I could be misremembering that. But I know she's definitely naked in 1, 2, 4, and 5. And it gets just progressively more explicit each time. And she is stupid hot, I'll give him that. And, you know, she's okay enough of an actress that she's fine as an antagonist, even if that antagonist just does not have a personality. So I think the movie ends up working nonetheless. You know, just being enough to get by.
Damn, I'm the punching bag for this round.
No.
Oh, I crashed. I'll be back.
Oh, I can't believe you've done this.
Haha, I must be the... I'm probably the leader now.
Anyway, so Blizzard, as in the video game company, Blizzard, has...
Is gay.
Yep. Yeah, they're gay. Yeah.
Oh, how did I see that coming?
How did you do that? How could you have possibly have done that? Yeah, Activision Blizzard has released a Pride line of clothing. Wow. Oh, boy, what news? What news?
You saw that coming. Jeez.
Who could have possibly seen that one? But actually... This is a distraction from the fact that they canceled PvE. So if you know,
yeah, that's what I was gonna.
If you don't know what that is, that's the whole reason that they were
the whole reason Overwatch 2.
Overwatch 2 was so that you could have go through a story section
and have like infinite PvE content.
And yeah, have a story that they would add on to. And they literally just gave up. They took Overwatch.
Like, oh, it's too hard.
They took the original Overwatch away from us. And gave us an incredibly inferior game that sucks. And all they do to add to it is add stupid transgender characters. And then they're like, you know what?
Yeah.
I don't think we screwed you
over. I don't
even
want
enough.
It anymore.
No, I never played the second one. I never opened it. I was just too upset about it.
Yeah, and you used to no like that game.
And apparently, I did.
I stopped playing good. When they turned Soldier 76 gay. I was like,
yeah. I was actually already playing at that point. I think it had already happened when I started playing. Anyway, but yeah, it was one of the few, like, massive... Hey, stop that. One of the few, like, online shooter games I was actually good at. Had some good times with that game. But... They took it away from us, Carmine! That was today!
Yeah, I reckon I was an OG then, since you came in after 76 being gay, because, dude,
yeah,
that was, like, way bad.
No, people were so mad because
am I covered in?
Like, nobody would play Symmetra because they, like, heavily nerfed her. But I never knew what she was like before. And I just got stupid good at her anyway. Symmetra was my main. And everybody's like, "Buh, you can't do that with Symmetra. What are you doing?" I'm like, "Yeah, I can. Shut up. Get good." I would
absolutely oh my gosh, you're not playing the meta
with that character.
You know how many trans characters do they have?
I mean, like, two?
Probably their whole roster.
Yeah, funny thing.
And everybody's gay. So, everybody's gay. Woo!
Yay. And let me guess, anybody who's not gay has a gay skin.
Probably. Yeah, there are Pride Month skins. And, yeah, you know, you can make them in the trans colors and all that. But yeah, it's a big distraction from the fact that they are absolute frauds and idiots.
Confident.
I would
oh,
like
that's a witch!
It. I shot it.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Oh, dude,
I'm trying to help you.
I got it. I went around the corner and instinctively shot it, and I just don't register that as a witch.
You know, I'm really annoyed because I have. I don't know if you've ever seen it, but I have this Overwatch jacket. And it's great. It's a great, great material, great, great color, fits like a glove. But it's a freaking Overwatch jacket.
Now you're
it's
ashamed
gay.
To wear it.
It's gay! And so I'm trying to think of ways.
Is it like Overwatch or is it like a specific character with the jacket?
Nah, it's
no,
Overwatch.
It's just Overwatch general. So I'm thinking of ways that I can spice it up. Because it's got a patch.
No, just take the emblems off of it.
Somehow. Well, okay, that's the problem. That was my thought. Because there's an emblem patch on the shoulder and then a little like tag on the front that says Overwatch. And so I'm trying to think of like, you know, I could take those off and then I could cover up the patch holes by putting a different patch there. But then,
oh, hello.
It's got a big symbol on the back that is actually imprinted into the jacket. Which means...
Is the symbol the Overwatch
is the symbol? Yeah, it's the Overwatch logo. So pretty much... What,
just make it into a different type of symbol.
No, it's you can't do that. It's literally dyed into the...
Sure you can.
My only option is to completely re-dye the jacket.
Or, wait, how big around
no,
it?
No, just change it a little bit.
It's like the whole, it covers the whole back. It's
oh,
huge.
Okay. I was about to say, if there's like 6 inches around, it makes jacket back patches. Specifically for the back.
No,
all you have
it's
to do is
big.
Alter it a little bit so it looks like a different symbol.
How? How in the world would I do that?
You would look up a similar symbol that means something else, and then you would just tweak it a little bit.
How would this,
whether it be
what would this
a Sharpie
tweaking,
or
what would this tweaking process
an overlay.
Be? I'm not going to be able to recreate...
Well, I have to look at your jacket.
I'm not going to be able to recreate the factory printing of the logo. That's not going to happen.
No, you just overlay. You just overlay it a little bit.
Yeah, so
okay,
so
you do
funny.
Realize that would be more challenging than just dyeing the whole jacket, right?
Okay, so look, this is my I'm gonna just say an example so you understand what I'm talking about. Alright. So you have like a big old zero
okay, this is
imprinted
pointless.
On your jacket, right?
Right.
Okay. So you wanna change it to something else because zero represents homosexuality, right?
Sure.
So you convert it into a C. How do you do that? Okay, so on the right side of the O, you overlay it with something, okay? I don't know what. Maybe some fabric, maybe some dyes, maybe some Sharpies, who knows?
My God.
All right. Of those would look horrible. Like, there would be nothing clean about that.
No, well, okay, so you'd find a one that's minuscule, like, you couldn't tell
like,
unless
what?
You really squinted at it, right? Well, I'd have to look at the jacket, but just hypothetically, okay? you're following my reasoning, right?
I'm following your reasoning. But I'm telling you, it's not gonna work.
Hypothetically, you could alter it just a little bit in some fashion so it won't look like the Overwatch symbol.
Hypothetically, okay? But I don't think that would work though. I think it could be done cleanly. I
altered my dress pants, right?
That's not the same at all.
I mean, your pants.
Right, I've done cosplay stuff like this, you know, patches, you know, dying hole stuff. And it's possible. But to do it cleanly would be super expensive. And painstaking.
I'm saying
it would be much easier just to redye the whole thing, cover it up. You know. And it would have to be something darker than the actual symbol, probably. I don't know. Depends on how long I did it, I guess.
Oh my gosh, Danny V.
I don't have any ammo.
HIV.
I was trying to get you, but I didn't have any ammo. And now Mike is dying. Oh my gosh. Reloading.
You're gonna have to suck it up. Oh, what? So many people.
Now Jensen's down again. Oh my gosh.
They're swarming me. What the
heck? Dude, we cannot separate like this, guys.
Oh my gosh. It's
horrible.
Let's get you up.
Dude, what in the world?
That's okay.
Micah? We lost.
I was about to tell him to heal himself.
Yes. Well, he's idle now. Hey, what's your name? Here you go. Oop, now it says he's gone.
He probably has connection. Jump
onto the truck. Yeah, he was having connection issues. Well.
Oh, I'm down here.
Micah, are you there? Micah.
I wasted that.
Yeah. You know, I actually can't think of a symbol you could turn that into.
Yeah, there's just.
Because I keep thinking of circular symbols, but the fact that it it points inwards with the triangle bits.
Yeah.
Like, well, how would you cover that at all?
Magic. Reloading. So interestingly, I don't know if Michael wants to hear this. Oh, damn it. Hit big time.
So Indiana Jones, tell us how you feel about that, Jensen.
Oh yeah, I had something real quick.
Well, I thought you wanted Micah to hear it.
Well, it was like on the same topic as Overwatch.
Well, I had something else for Overwatch too, and I was waiting.
Alright, whatever. Right.
So,
I will be. You know what? You know the Alex Jones clip.
Which one?
I gotta send you that one. Oh, I gotta send you that clip. There's this clip where he's like, "I will be. You know what?" And he just starts like cursing.
We can get up here.
About these idiots who are running something badly. I'll send you the clip. It's amazing.
Okay.
I don't know. I don't know what I'll do. I'm gonna be very mad. I know I am. I never got my hopes up, but like now I can't see anything good coming from this at all. Like, I thought that it could be decent, because Mads Mikkelsen was the bad guy, and that's great. Yeah.
Oh no!
I didn't even see it.
I didn't see it either. I didn't hear it. Oh! Okay.
Run away.
I got wrecked.
Jack, you bitch. It's running away? No Alice help. Alice is just standing there.
Ah, come on. Can't stay down there. We got zombies to. How do you feel about it, though?
Dude, it killed you and ran away. I wanted it to be good, but like I never. How do I explain it? I didn't actually think it would be a great movie. I thought it would be, from the beginning, I thought it would be another just indie 4, you know?
Yep.
Okay. I thought, you know, it'd be okay because we heard some of the casting and some other production stuff. We saw Mangold was on the list, and I had just seen Ford versus Ferrari, which was amazing.
That was a great movie.
And now I know he's lost his way. And that, I think what really... And in the beginning killed it for me was Phoebe Waller-Bridge's involvement.
Yeah, that was a bad sign.
She kills everything she touches, and then we saw that episode of Fleabag. Holy shit. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, she has like, you know, she can act no doubt, but she just has no charm at all.
And I fucking love that property.
Right.
I own Raiders of the Lost Ark in almost every format it's been released on, all but two formats for the U.S. releases that it's been released on. I own all of it. Like, no one can stop me from watching that movie. You can break any of my players, I'll still be able to watch it. And, you know, I have the entire...
Can't take it away from me!
Yeah, yeah, I have, like, the canon book run that's, like... Here. Or 9 or 12, I'd have to look at my bookshelf, and I've read 3 of them, and they're pretty good. You know, I have a few of the video games. Those are, some of them are fun, some of them are antiquated just because they're old.
Mm-hmm.
What's happening?
I have the Atari game, too. In box. Like, it's a great property.
What's going on here?
Great stories, and it's a trilogy.
We're,
you heard
we're
me. It's a trilogy.
Talking about Indiana Jones,
and I don't see how they can destroy that.
Although you know,
I mean, sorry, I said that wrong. I don't see why. What would possess a person to look at this and be like, you know what? Let's change this. We don't like it the way it is. Here. Who looks at
wait,
that?
Wait, they're changing the older movies,
it's
or
no.
It's Indiana Jones in general.
Well, it's because Kathleen Kennedy is doing the exact same thing she does with every character. So it's just more of her insecurities. That's why. You know, like I said earlier, she's just being Jake Skywalker. So. What was your thing about Blizzard? You had something to say about Blizzard.
Me?
We'll come back to Indiana Jones, believe me.
Yeah, we can go back to that one. But,
I had
no,
something
Jensen
to say about Blizzard?
No, Jensen did.
Okay.
I had something about Blizzard?
You said you were...
Oh, well, it was somewhat related to just no-lifing a online shoot-em-up was... And them turning things gay was... You know, you guys know what Rainbow Six Siege is, right?
Yep.
Yeah, I was really damn good at that. So good that I only played competitive because, well, they called it ranked. Because playing normal, I was just too good at it. And it was boring. I was, like, really damn good. It was, like, right before the pandemic and a little bit during the pandemic. All I played, really freaking good at it, and I haven't touched it since. Pandemic. And if I were to go back on it, I'd probably be very horrible.
I heard that game was cancer.
No, it's still
Saul actually plays that. No, I know it's still Glenn. I heard like the community is cancer and a lot of the Ubisoft goals.
So they somewhat instigated that. Guys, protect me, I got the Coke.
The Coca-Cola.
No one grab a pipe bomb.
Heaven,
I got it. Protect me.
Run.
I'm running.
Yeah, anyway, it is a little bit toxic. Some of the players can be toxic, but I mean, if you can ignore them.
Dude.
Whatever.
Well, Saul plays a lot with his buddies, right?
Yeah.
There is like an abundance of people who will like DDoS you.
What?
DDoS attack you. Basically knock you off of your own internet service. Just because they lost, or because they're like playing ranked and they want to win. It's insane. Yeah, DDoS attack onto your No. You don't know what a DDoS is?
No. I play on PC and ranked. If they don't want you there, they vote to kick you. That's all they can do.
Well, yeah, the vote to kick was also pretty bad. I think they got rid of that. I think so. But yeah, DDoS attack is basically you spam. You find somebody's internet router, right? So you find like their not their IP, but like their personal internet, right? And then you spam their router with so much info that it like knocks it offline, so it can't handle the data. And so it'll
stupid amount of hacking, and I question how legal that is.
Oh no, it's not legal, but it's prevalent. I don't know about computer, but especially on Xbox.
Yeah, I never had that happen to me.
It's really funny.
But yeah, it's not funny, toxic. I mean, I may go back and play this game, who knows. But basically, after I left, I did the same situation was they introduced the trans thing.
Yeah.
And of course, all the gamer lingo and all the gamer talk, people constantly made fun of it. Of course. This is gamers you're dealing with. What did you think was gonna happen? And of course, anybody who played that character got made fun of. And then, basically, if you were reported for making fun of a person for playing as a gay trans person, you were banned. So basically, they used that as a way to ban anybody who thought differently. And this was right after I quit, because it was too toxic for me. You know, I'm like, you know what, I'm here to have fun and relax after work. And, you know, I was working on critics. This is not relaxing for me.
Who the hell is Thaddeus Griffin?
You didn't say Friday.
I must. Hey, I must not have. I usually do.
My boy Thaddeus over here. Oh, maybe he can carry us.
Basically, they had the gay character, and then introduced little gay keychains for your guns, or gun skins, or pride flags, to promote to these people. So anybody who having a good time making fun of trans people or whatever, or making gay jokes, like dudes just
that's
do.
Not allowed.
Dudes just make gay jokes, all right? And you'd get kicked for it. There was no investigation, no argument. Oh, if they reported you for harassment for trans character stuff, immediately gone.
Dang.
So yeah, just like Jaeden, the online shoot first-person shooter game that I know lifed right after I left, it became quite horrible apparently.
Huh.
Yeah. Sucks.
Yeah. Okay, so it's a little deserted.
Ongoing
there
thing.
Might still be an evac deeper in.
I think it's really funny.
Lucky for me, I have infinite amount of games.
I mean, I might return to it. I mean, I'll probably get banned, but...
Yeah, just return and get banned. Like, actively try to get banned.
I'm playing that game, and I legitimately enjoyed that game. Playing that game before it just got too toxic during the pandemic when everybody was home. There was, like, everybody, all toxic people on all at once. Like, sometimes you could kind of gauge at what time of day those people would be on, and then you just get off. you'd kind of know what time of day to play that game. I don't remember what times it was. It's been 4 years.
Yeah.
But yeah, I knew what times to play that game, and then you'd hit a certain time of day, it would suddenly get toxic, and then you'd get off. But then the pandemic hit, everyone was home, toxic all the time. I quit. No.
Mm-hmm.
No. I get enough shit from my coworkers.
Yeah. It's a very stressful game.
Hey, it wasn't for me at first.
Well, it's because you have so much, like...
Fun.
Well, there's so much, like, competition, and then all your teammates and your enemies are, like, very malicious. Not at all constructive. They're just like, you suck, you should kill yourself, and,
It's also a little annoying.
Everything is your fault.
They had a newcomer mode where you couldn't play it. You could only play it if you're level 50 or below. And I was, like, level 80-something. So, any friends I have that played that game, I couldn't play it with them because I was too high level.
And they're like, you were too good at this game.
So basically, I was too good at the game and I couldn't play games with my friends. So yeah,
that's
I just moved down to other games. I think I moved on to Killing Floor too. Mm. I still play that game. That game is still fun. I like that game. It's, you know, you shoot demonic beings. There's not a whole lot of crap you can do.
I actually have that game. I could play that as well.
Depending on the volume, yeah, that'd be a good game for the stream. I don't know.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
Oh, you should
buy it. Yeah, you can buy it when you...
Oh my
money.
Gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Modded. Look, he just...
he just executed that witch.
Yeah, he's modding. Let's keep him on.
Yeah, let's see.
Yeah.
Might actually get through this mode.
I mean, we're doing pretty good beforehand.
Yeah, we're doing okay. We are in the early levels, though.
Most people in video games ruining it for us. Watch out
for a second. Yeah, I don't know why they keep trying to hit the gamers, who are like the nastiest, most intolerable people. Like why? How stupid are you?
Gamers be inclusive.
Steam store page for
like that soap company, Dove.
Oh, Dove. Yeah, stay out of gaming.
Calling for to have fat.
Body positivity.
Yeah, fat female protagonists in video games, and they had that really stupid ad, and it's like, what in the world is this?
Well, they had a whole string. They had wheelchair-ridden people, too.
Why in the world is this soap company preaching to us about how video games should be made?
They want fat people to be a thing because they need more soap to clean more body.
Like,
more surface area.
Exactly.
I get it.
Sell more soap.
Makes sense.
They're actually being very smart with their decisions.
Yeah, but they should know that gamers don't use soap. Like, you should be catering to them, not giving them the old preachy preach. Search these rooms. You guys coming or what?
Where are you?
I'm always coming.
Do not come. Do not
I don't know where I'm going. Oh shit, I'm the wrong way. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, DDoS attacks are no joke.
Yeah, never had a DDoS.
I don't know.
I've never had one.
It's not good. It'll knock you off of like your internet router for a couple hours, I think.
Do not.
Luckily,
I'm not doing it.
Luckily, I use a phone, and Saul uses a phone, so every time. Like, they would DDoS him. It's just a phone, so it doesn't... like, oh. Nothing really happened. It's specifically routers that are... susceptible.
Yeah, that would suck.
And that happens with websites, too. Like, you can harass a website by doing...
I gotta heal before we open the door, or you're gonna die.
That is a good idea. But yeah, websites and social... media platforms and all that can be DDoS as well. If you find the servers.
Yeah, I went on the Steam page for Dead by Daylight. Sometimes on the online games, they'll just have like a video playing of somebody live streaming the game and just like drag.
Dead by Daylight has a big gay community.
I know they do, but so like I'm worried that they're gonna start doing stuff.
I mean, they kind of already have a little bit.
And they're already pretty toxic, that's for sure.
There's a gay guy. I don't remember if there's any trans dudes.
You know, speaking of Dead by Daylight, that really brings us to our next segment, which is the announcement that Nicolas Cage is going to be a playable character.
What?
Dude,
we don't know if he's going to be killer or survivor.
I hope he's killer.
But it is, it's literally just him in a bathrobe. It's pretty hilarious.
That's amazing. I'll pay money for that.
Yep. And of course, it's actually, you know, it looks like him. It's voiced by him.
Well, I thought it would be like a movie tie-in, right? Like a horror movie thing. But you're saying it's like the actual actor?
Yeah,
as the actor?
Yeah, it's literally Nicolas Cage as Nicolas Cage.
Okay, that's pretty funny.
Yeah, it is.
Come on, hacker man. Pick us up. Cheat the game.
Hell yeah. But yeah, it looks like there's going to be some sort of a movie set map, and you'll get Nicolas Cage in his bathroom. So,
in his bathroom.
Whether survivor or killer, it's going to be pretty epic.
I don't understand.
I don't know which do you think he's going to be?
Survivor.
Yeah, probably a survivor. But it would be funny if he was a killer.
Yeah.
Like,
who's going to be the killer, though, that would go along with Nick Cage? Would it be another actor like that? Like Willem Dafoe or something?
They should get Gary Busey since he does that stuff.
No. Gary Busey would totally do it because Gary Busey voiced Badass Santa in the Christmas DLC for Killing Floor 2. So Gary Busey would totally do that.
That would be so funny. Nicolas Cage versus Gary Busey.
Dude, that would be freaking awesome. Oh, okay.
He has a defib.
He literally just died.
Oh, I've fallen and I can't get up.
I'll get you.
No dropping from 10 feet would break my legs.
Failure. You didn't bend at the knees.
Yep. Stop shocking me!
Oh, you're up, Jensen.
I'm alive. Nice. Oh shit, I dropped.
You're in the walls.
In the walls.
No,
almost there.
That dude's totally
so slow. Oh, there we go. Healing.
It's all on us. No one is going to be rescuing us today.
Dang. So, just 7 months after declaring New York City an illegal immigrant sanctuary, the mayor, Eric Adams, says that New York is overwhelmed.
He said that a long time ago. He said, don't bring any more. That's old news.
No, that was...
Unless he's saying it again.
No, that was this week. You're thinking of... when people were upset.
Oh no no! Wait,
when he was upset when he was upset about the drop off with the buses, that was hilarious.
Oh yeah, that's what.
And he said, "Stop bringing them here." But no. He declared New York City a sanctuary for illegals, and they responded pretty well. There's about 70,000 of them in New York City.
We need to get going.
Oh my.
Which has been really fun for crime, of course, which is already terrible because of their various dumb policies.
The more the merrier.
So he's calling for other states to take the burden.
How about no?
And he did use the word burden, by the way.
No.
Oh, damn it.
Is he calling Hispanics a burden?
Maybe South America just stops being a piece of shit place to live, and you wouldn't have to stop.
It's true.
Easy. Invade South America.
I mean, that, yeah, no.
And all their people.
That's what I've been saying,
here,
man.
Why not just enlist them?
Yeah, we take over South America and we take over Canada.
And the immigrants and the immigrants and the soldiers.
So imperialistic.
And then we take over Canada.
We take over. Well, okay. I was saying South
America.
Canada. Canada too.
Canada has more natural resources.
That's true. All right, I have to head out. It's late.
All right, get out of here.
Well,
what? You gotta finish the mission, man.
Just as Thaddeus Griffin goes idle. Dang.
Oh man.
Well, good night, all.
Night.
It's a shame I didn't get to complain enough about Indiana Jones 5.
You'll get more chances, plenty more.
Well, there's, yeah, how many weeks? We got 2 months. Well, 1.5 months till the release, so.
Yep.
That's at least 7 Tuesdays.
No, it's about a month and a week.
I will complain about it.
5 Tuesdays. 5 streams.
Yeah, about 5 streams.
The rest of the year to complain about after.
And ladies and gentlemen, you can look forward to a video. I will be reviewing it.
Or 5.
Ready to get mad!
Make Indiana Jones your number one thing in GTA 5, or Phoebe Waller-Bridge to your number one thing you are known about. Just known about destroying, like Roderick is known for destroying Rings of Power. Making Indiana Jones and the Dial of Disney the thing.
One. Yes.
Reloading!
So many freaking gas cans.
What a bitch.
Gotta reload.
All right. Well, good night, kids.
Get off me.
Anyway, so Eric Adams, his solution is hilarious. It's one of the funniest I've literally one of the funniest I've ever heard. He said,
I got this one.
He was like, well, we should divide the illegals throughout the different cities. He literally said that. We'll take a bunch of them and we'll ship
equity
them
for all
to each American city. And then it'll... And then
or
it'll
you could deport them. You could do the deporting. Huh?
You know, just like with California, their solution is
socialism. Is
they should be exactly like us. We're suffering, but let's share it around.
Oh, I'm on fire! Yeah, let's share around our suffering. I don't understand why the solution is not deportation. Like what? I don't. Do you understand this? Do you understand?
Go faster, come on, go. Go on,
like, what is going on here?
Because people are dumb.
Oh. Because
Eric Adams is dumb. You know, he's like, he annoys me. Because he's one of those guys he's one of those politicians who goes up and preaches about everything, even though he's the one in charge. So he's one of the main contributors to the mess that they're in right now. But then he's all like changing his tune recently by going, "Oh man, what's up with all this crime? Somebody's got to do something about this crime. Something's got to change." And it's like, yeah, why don't you fucking do something?
Why don't you stop doing what you have been doing?
This is what you were elected to deal with. And you're like, man, somebody should do something about it. And I hate it so much. I hate it when politicians do that. We need to clean up
something
this city.
Needs to
yeah, get on with it, man. Reloading. How many years have you been sitting in this position? Like, dude. Just absolutely stupid. Absolutely nuts.
I got two gas cans. Can I throw it? No.
Nope. But yeah, his solution was just hilarious to me.
Why don't we take Bikini Bottom and push it somewhere else?
Like, that's all he said.
Literally a Patrick moment.
Like, you dumbass. Reloading here. Because, you know, that doesn't account for all of the other illegals, you know, going across the border in droves. You know, we're not going to... You know, our economy can't sustain all of these people spending and not paying taxes and making the streets a mess by being homeless and trafficking all kinds of things. Like, you can't just not vet people. That's what England is learning the hard way with all of their stabbings and stuff.
More gas. Get in here.
Hell yeah.
There's nobody in the car. What the
heck? Oh, there was something I forgot about the... to say about the Blizzard Pride stuff. They have this one that is why does it say that you're the lobby leader? I can't change the map because you're the leader.
Change the map.
The map.
Is it streets?
It's just whatever the second one is. No, not the second map. We got to the end of... Yeah, it's not chapter. It's new campaign. We finished that one. We finished Dead Center. So it's the one after Dead Center.
Oh, the passing.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
Anyway, they had this t-shirt that says Blizzard in transgender flag colors, but if you read just the pink letters, it says liar. And I don't know if that's just really stupid design or an employee just absolutely done with this stuff or what, but I thought that was...
You just slipped it in there.
Pretty hilarious. Pretty hilarious. But, I mean, fair enough. That's Blizzard for you.
Hey, can you lower the bridge so we can get our car?
They're liars.
No. Oh. Do we need to know some sort of...
Oh, I just love this map.
No.
Oh, yeah. We need Thaddeus.
Out of gas. Yeah.
He left us.
Well, I guess we'll take it.
I think we're just going to die continuously until the stream ends, I think is what's going to happen.
What was the other, what was the topic we were talking about? We were on a topic, but then you were like, by the way, I forgot about this Blizzard thing.
Oh, we were talking about hey, look out. New York City being overwhelmed by 70,000 illegal immigrants.
Oh, yeah.
And becoming a cesspool because of it.
Well, I just very, very simple. It's one word. Deportate.
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 There's a charger around. There's a reason that there's a system. It's so that, you know, crazy criminals and gang members can't just, you know, be allowed to exist in the city and have a business.
Holy shit, that thing's
and vote and not pay taxes just because diversity. Because all
just
of that is very absurd.
I'm, just be- I'm sad
yeah,
that
just
they're
just because you jumped the border, you're a Mexican who jumped the border, doesn't mean you're above the law. I don't know what's hard to understand about that.
Everything, because they speak Spanish. They don't speak the English, man.
I don't know why it isn't hard for anyone else to understand. Like, the politicians, they profit from a good economy, and they're like, how about we just screw it up as much as possible? It's that short-term business you were talking about, right?
Mm-hmm.
We had too many politicians in a row who would just mooch and leave. That's why it was nice to have, like, Trump, who's, you know, stupid...
He's not in it for the profit.
Yeah, stupid rich and therefore has no real agenda of his own.
He's a very patriotic priority list. He wants to make America great again. Yep. Simple.
And who better than a successful businessman to, you know, crank up that economy? And
yep.
I mean, we were all right on that one. He certainly did.
Now we got Joe Biden.
He needed a lot more time to, you know, polish things off, for sure. But he definitely made the
we have guns here.
Economy better for a hot minute there.
The average Joe.
Oh my god. I'm telling you, for the next 40 minutes of the stream,
he's finally
dead.
Well,
yeah.
Oh, hi, Mark. Yep, short-term gain. Nobody's looking long-term because they're it's called elected office is only 2 to 4 years, so they're like, well, as long as I make a lot of money and appear to be doing my job, then I can be as negligent as possible and not,
well, not even
have any
job,
like, responsibility. Yeah,
they're not good at pretending to do their job.
Well, yeah, but they're just trying to keep up appearances. There's no, like, genuine effort to solve problems. Ah! Like, DeSantis is genuinely trying to solve problems. He's
a
very honest.
Such a great speed. Like, he says something's gonna get done, and a few weeks later, you've got it, and you're like, "Damn,
Right.
Like, I can't name many politicians who do that. We're always used Follows to that through. Agonizing, like, waiting period.
Right. Oh. Oh, Lord.
Sorry about that. He was like, in front of a car and I couldn't shoot him.
We need a lot more politicians like that that are just very genuine and not in it for fame or money or to look morally good. We need, like,
stand still,
good Christian
or I'm gonna mess this up.
Men leading.
Mm-hmm. Well, not just good men, but strong men. Because we got plenty of, you know, you got quite a few good Christian men on the right, but it's just like they're
no,
not
like
they're not
strong
they're
leaders,
not
ag- I guess.
They're not aggressive enough.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah,
and they usually
well, it's not specifically in our doctrine to, you know, like have like again, it's not like the Quran, right, where you go into a system and you basically make it Sharia law.
Right.
We're more like local community focused. And that doesn't necessarily mean like governmental body. So our Christian what are they called? The Christian creed? I don't
Move
know.
Forward, Nick is standing in the smoke like an idiot. Thank you.
Christian creed.
Yeah, I know, but I think, you know, I think too many Christians focus on the, you know, be the peacemakers command, which, you know, we should do.
Yeah.
I'm not saying we shouldn't, but, you know, they're not focusing enough on
Coach, you should maybe
a little
heal.
Bit of righteous action, which you could go to, you could go too far with, but, you know, I'm saying, like,
yeah, there's none of it right
like
now.
They just don't have it at all, you know, and then they're not being like Jesus. Like, we're supposed to constantly strive to be like Jesus, and, you know, he flipped over tables in anger and
whipped people.
Yeah, whipped people, rebuked people pretty firmly.
So I think spoke his mind always.
Yeah. Wasn't quiet, wasn't afraid of what people were gonna do to him or try to do to him.
Girl, you should have stayed at home.
Right.
Reloading. And yeah. So yeah, you like Christian men,
we need to
know,
get into
need
the
to
building.
Learn that part of being that strong leader, firm leader is using at least a little, just a tad of that aggression to your advantage.
Yeah.
Reloading.
That's when these go down.
Because you gotta be, you know, fair, but also firm. It's firm but fair. Speak softly.
Yeah.
Carry a big stick and all that. And
carry a big stick between your legs.
It seems like everybody is one or the other.
That zombie's carrying something.
Yeah.
You know, a strong leader must be even-handed.
Reload.
Well-balanced, well-rounded.
Yeah. I think Trump would benefit greatly if he was a tad bit more, like, Christian, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
'Cause he's...
If he was, like, more tactful with his words and stuff.
Yeah, I have a feeling he's like, you know, those Jews that are like, yeah, I'm Jewish, right? He's like, yeah, I'm Christian, but he's not like actively.
Oh. Dang it. She one-shotted me.
Not like actively applying that to his life. At least not to the extent that he should.
Yeah, he's still being too much of that, like, bitey businessman, where he just...
Yeah.
Where a lot of his talk is, like, slandering his opponents to an unnecessary degree.
Yeah. Right, so I think he needs to, you know... refocus his morals and stuff.
Like I said, everyone is always one or, you know, more the other. You're either... Reloading! It seems like either you have good principles and you're limp-wristed, or your principles are, you know, less than optimal.
Questionable.
And you're more on the aggressive side.
Yeah. Seems to be the case.
You gotta get somewhere in the middle.
Somewhere in the middle.
In the middle.
That would be nice.
That would be nice.
I can't see! Can't see a bloody thing! What the heck is going on?
So I got a... So I got one more topic here.
Oh my.
And it's Netflix. Who just... Has just been in... Just been enjoying money less and less recently. They announced a new show called The Core. As in C-O-R-P-S. Corpse. The Core. About gay marines in the 90s.
Oh my.
It will follow the struggle of a bullied gay teen who becomes a marine with his straight best friend and meets other
And then grooms him to be gay.
Gay marines. And yeah, inevitably grooms him.
Don't forget to close the door.
And the posters for this series are like really badly like AI generated. Like super obvious that they're AI generated. And they're posters of marines in pink helmets and pink shirts along with their teams.
Oh my gosh. Close the door.
And I don't think anyone will watch this. The Core.
Yeah, I think this is going to save Netflix.
Gay
yeah.
Marines will save That's... Netflix.
Close that bitch.
Yeah.
That was some epic
like they saved the Middle East. It'll be the same. Same effectiveness level. Yeah, pretty stupid. And I love that they're doing this after the Amazon data, the Amazon Prime data, where they found out that audiences generally don't like gay storylines. They're like, you know what? We'll cater to them anyway. We'll you know, like...
So Ellis.
When it comes to business, catering to minorities is not always...
I was thinking of her too, Nick.
Good idea. Yeah, I'm like, sensing a trend here.
Like, sometimes it's good if you get, like, a niche market, but... Yeah, if you're this big company totally that's supposed to have this big general audience... Then you don't spend a bunch of money on stuff that general audience is not really gonna take to.
We ready?
It's not rocket
no, preferably
science.
Preferably not. Obviously, these companies do not have common sense.
Nope.
That zombie's sharing something.
What the heck? Does he have like? Oh,
here.
He has supplies.
Ooh,
well.
Nice. Supply zombie.
That's cool.
Yeah, you get those in the harder difficulties.
The Core.
The Core. I don't know about you, Michael, but Game Marines is always what I've wanted to see in a television show.
Yeah, man. That's so...
I was just wondering. I was watching Justice League this morning. And I was like, man,
I'm reloading.
This could use some more gay marines. Where are all the gay marines at? Where are they? Who are they? What do they want other than other men?
That is probably the most unappealing type of story.
Who's the audience?
Just gay.
It's so funny. Just gay. The point
gay
is gay.
Military.
There's no plot. It's just about a guy who's gay. That's your synopsis. He's gay.
Like, you can get away with a lot more, like, lesbian storylines, right? Because that's attractive.
Yeah, but you can... As long as you like, cast gay... I mean, as long as you cast hot women, then, yeah.
Right, if you cast hot women, then it can work. The lesbians, right? Mm-hmm. Then you have more of a general audience, because, like, most men are going to be like, alright, but...
Alright.
But gay men, like, who... I don't think women want to see that, and I know for sure men do not want to see that.
Yeah, because they're not it. Because they're not as visual. They're more contextual in their attraction. Yeah. So, you know, men love lesbian porn, but there isn't a significant amount of women watching gay porn.
Oh yeah,
and
that's
why.
What I'm talking about.
So yeah, I mean, the show just really doesn't have much of an audience. I don't know what they were going for. It's just a lot of stupid.
We can climb in through the window.
Climbing through the window. Oh. Ellis. God dang.
Take it, just take it.
That'll keep you for a bit. We might need these.
Nice.
Drop down here. I don't know what else to say about that.
I mean,
not really surprising, is it?
There's not
help.
Much like
help.
Other commentary other than
I'm gonna die.
What we've stated.
Here I go. Goodbye.
Here I go again. I can't get back up there.
I'm over here.
I can't get back up there, man.
Reloading.
It happens.
Ooh.
It happens.
Incendiary ammo.
Fire bullets. Deploying fire bullets.
Careful, SpongeBob. Careful, SpongeBob.
SpongeBob, careful.
Yes.
Why did it play when I put down the ammo thing?
What did it say? Oh, the careful SpongeBob.
I put down the incendiary ammo and it said, careful, SpongeBob. Careful, SpongeBob.
I don't know.
I thought that happened with the green stuff.
Yeah, the bile.
Careful.
That's usually when
that's
that
so
happens.
Rude. Is I think the sounds are just bugged.
Maybe.
I have so many mods, probably. Reloading. They're overlapping.
I have a lot of buggy mods.
First aid kit here.
Oh, there I am. Showtime.
Hey,
epic.
Hey, yo. Where do we go? I don't know.
Ellis is just casually standing in the fire.
Such a Chad.
Why do they not update the NPC programming in this game? Oh, here we go.
Chocolate.
Watch out!
Keep setting things on fire. Can't go through the doorway. There's too much fire.
Freaking fire. Isn't here. Oh my.
Oh my gosh.
There's a lot of Molotovs.
Throw them everywhere!
Molotov coming!
Throw the perimeter! Yes!
Burn the perimeter.
Oh, Nick's gonna die. Whoops. There he is.
Oh, burn the tank!
Oh, that's
I died.
Girl, you should have stayed at home.
Shit, this hurts.
Well, that sucks.
Ouch. Damn, didn't even get to know you, coach.
My leg! My leg!
Cover me. I'm going to patch myself up.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm feeling right.
Where am I going? Here, I guess.
Oh, no. So, if I reckon if Dead Island goes back on sale, I can buy that. Because that was pretty good back in the day. I played with my friends.
Yeah, I'll make like, sure Jensen.
First aid kit.
Reloading. Yeah. That was pretty good for what it was.
Make sure you keep your eyes on the Borderlands games if you don't have those.
Oh yeah.
Well, the first two at least. I'm gonna reload. Hold it up. Reloading.
The third was okay, but it was like, I don't know, it just felt kind of shallow in a couple of different areas.
I've only played the first two. I have the pre-sequel and I'm planning on playing it, but I never really got into it. Oh yeah, and I played Tales from the Borderlands. That was a great one.
Tales from the Borderlands.
By shooting each other.
What?
Oh, I finished that.
Reloading.
The last of that. Peach Moonshine last night. And I drank it straight while Jensen and I were playing Resident Evil 5. Why are you all idle? Come on, follow me. Follow me, NPCs. Stupid NPC.
You drank the whole. Wait, how much did you drink?
No, I finished it off. It was like. It was like two fingers.
Oh, okay.
More than I usually drink of something if I'm drinking it straight.
Jesus, this place and, sucks.
And. Gosh, it actually kind of hurt my mouth.
I mean. I can imagine.
Reloading!
Stuff's pretty potent.
Yeah. Just so strong.
It's moonshine,
like not,
so
like not really like burning, but like it made my mouth kind of numb.
And so that's what moonshine does.
It's sort of
pretty...
like just like regular pain, you know, like I had been punched.
It's just regular pain. You get punched in the mouth.
Yeah, that's kind of what it felt like.
It's a good punch to the mouth.
So yeah, it was... That was kind of tough. But then I kept drinking it, so, you know. Oh, this is horrible!
I like pain.
Oh, so horrible. Oh, man. It never stops being horrible.
Ow. Maybe this time. Maybe this time. Maybe this time.
Set everything on fire.
And
then I walked into the fire. What the fuck? There's a bug on me.
Where are we going? Oh.
Onward.
I got it. Cool.
Driver here.
Chocolate.
Did you see that? That Reload. Soap commercial about the video games? Did you know what we were talking about?
No. You should link it in the Discord or something.
I hope phase 2 is as good as phase 1.
Yeah.
I'm interested.
Where's Nick? I'm gonna
see the...
Shit. You gotta keep moving so I can
Yeah, it's
you.
Pretty funny because it starts out with like your standard... like female protagonist. She's not too bad looking.
Reloading.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how the hell are we supposed to get around her?
Oh my.
Oh, I did it.
I've done an oopsie.
Did you fall?
I was running away from the witch, and then, yeah.
That's funny. Anyway, and so she's like battling dragons or something like that, I don't remember. And she's like progressively taking off armor and like getting fatter. It's almost like a comedy cartoon, like almost like it's making fun of fatness, even though it isn't. And you know, like she takes off like a neck thing, and her chin bulges out, and you know, she's just like taking
it's
off
like one of those,
armor and like just.
It's like one of those vor things.
Almost.
You get like eaten.
Yeah, it was.
That's
it
what
was
it sounds
like. That. Yep.
I hear a smoke.
First aid kit here.
Thought it was pretty funny.
So, she inflates herself, and then what? She says, buy my soap.
Just saying.
Holler back at me when you're ready to get me.
Reloading! Oh, man.
Oh, hi, Mark.
Hey, I'm too big a man for this little closet.
Where am I? Oh, I'm right here.
I'm trapped in here.
I think I really heard
hey,
something.
Hey, y'all! We're a team! Come get me!
What's up, Mark?
Ammunition! Get ready to go once we hit this button. I hit it!
God damn it, back in the shit wall!
Oh, hey, you're not dead anymore. Micah?
Can you cut that out? I need some help.
Micah, where did you go? Michael, where did you go?
You're kidding, right?
Yeah, ha ha ha. A little bit more handsome, you wouldn't be in this mess.
That was so nice and gentle,
you
wasn't
are
it?
Gonna love the Under the River tour.
Under the what now?
I want this. Stick around till Micah comes back.
On black.
Micah, where did you
go? On black. Did we die?
Yeah, because I didn't realize you had gone somewhere. Because I was talking to someone else and I didn't hear you. And you came back and then died immediately. And then the rest of us died.
All right. What were you saying?
It was bad.
About the ad. Time my buddy Keith
got married. Oh yeah. Of course not. That's a trick question. I just thought that it was like weirdly comedic. Even though it was trying to be
serious.
Yes, really it was serious the about time, the message. Okay? Like it was just like actually offensive.
Dang.
hilarious.
Oh, well. You said that was all the topics, right?
Oh. Yeah. Also, I'm 23, apparently.
Wait, what?
Yep.
Why did you say these things?
Because I am.
But why did you need to say that, though?
Well, I didn't need to say it.
What?
Never mind, forget about it.
But, like, the context, there was no context. There was just like, by the way.
That's alright. So,
what?
So. Corey, anything of some to cry about? Dude, why do the NPCs follow you and not me?
I'm just superior.
I'm gonna die. Right out the gate.
Well, if that's all the topics, I'll probably be like a bit, because I have to wake up.
Let me check the time.
Do things.
Can you give me 14 more minutes?
What's the time? Why?
I'm trying to reach a certain length.
just have you there eating like food for 14 minutes watching a YouTube video. Just.
I can't do that.
That's like, stupid. Sorry guys, I need to pad out the watch time.
Hey, I'm watching
the latest Eaters video.
I'm better at my job than that.
And react to things like the rest of the internet.
I'm dying again. Now I'm dead.
Man.
Dang. Barely made it out the gate. Barely. Let me look something up real quick. Yo, coach.
Dude, where's the zombies at, bro? I wanna die. Here you go.
Well, you gotta be a. You gotta help your teammate.
I wanna kill myself.
How about this? Andrew Tate says men need to drop by and see their kids once a month for 2 hours to be a good father. Once a month for 2 hours.
Yeah, this is terrible advice.
Explain to me why that's terrible advice.
just some things in this world does not need to be explained.
it's just bad, man. Just bad.
It's like saying water is just a an option. You don't have to drink it. It's like, is that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You need to be in your son's life. You need to be an example. A role model, a teacher, have a relationship with the child. Like, I don't understand. left the game.
Yeah. We'll just set in the menu for 10 minutes. I'm not even going to try. I'm tired of the sound effects and the music.
I'm just watching the bots run around.
That would be funny. But I think once you die, it cops out.
Andrew Tate is... His moral system comes from Islamic, like, teachings. And, like, the bastardization of Islamic teachings, so not even, like, traditional Islamic values.
Yeah.
So... His morals are very skewed, especially when it comes to, like, priorities and how you treat people and how you view women and men. So, very bad role model in a lot of ways, even if he does say some based things. So, yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah. Have you seen that video of that that English guy who was making like TikTok trends of just walking into random people's houses?
He walked into random people's houses.
Yeah. And video himself like getting yelled at.
How do you walk into somebody's house?
Just pick someone who's got, like, door. An unlocked door, like, if they're standing in their garden or someone, or something like that.
Dude, you get shot in the U.S., like, there would
That's
be no...
That's what I was thinking. You'd get shot so fast.
And rightfully so, you should be shot, you stupid idiot. Oh, my gosh.
Yep. It escalated. Like, he'd do stupid stuff in stores or, like, get into random people's cars. Like, just get in the back of their car. And, of course, he's been arrested for all kinds of things. And people are like, yeah, this is cool. Let's do that, too. And it's like, dang. You guys are lucky to live in... You live in England.
Average British man.
Because here in America, you would just die. Trying to...
Yeah.
And that's the way it should be, honestly. Like, there should be incentives to not break the law. That's how you keep people safe.
Right. Don't invade somebody else's privacy and property.
Yep. You shouldn't be able to just walk into people's houses. That's not a good place to live. By any stretch of the imagination. It's funny, though. I guess.
Have you seen the have you seen that one guy? He's called the I don't remember what he's called, but he's like cart monitor, cart cop or something. He runs around different grocery stores in different like states, and he basically calls everyone out when they don't put the cart back into the little cart zone.
No, I haven't seen that.
Oh my goodness. He's made a whole channel about it, and he, like, sternly talks to them, and, he's, like, polite about it, and he just harasses people. It's like, sir, you did not put your cart back. Like, what's going on here? Why are you being so uncivilized and stuff like that? And some people act, like, very... good about it, and some people act very bad about it, like very, very upset about it.
That's funny.
I forget his channel though. You should definitely watch some of his videos. At least some of the people react to him. His videos, because they're funny.
Oh yeah, let me get
the videos themselves here.
Let me get you that Dove video.
It's like cart. That's gonna bug me. Cart something. Cart curator. Cart commentator. No. Yeah, he almost got shot a few times.
Dang, really? Yeah. People are so dramatic.
It was funny because he has like these stickers that he puts on the cars if they don't put the cart back. So they'll get in the car and he'd be like, well, you're getting this naughty sticker or something like that because you didn't put the cart back. Some people get like really, really irritated that you put the sticker on their car.
Give me just a second, Micah.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
You can keep telling the audience about that.
Hold on, I need to speak into this mic right now. I've seen pictures of this Beth, and she's so hot.
Hmm?
She's so hot. Hear me?
Yeah, he can hear you.
Oh my gosh, Micah, this is amazing. How did you do it? She's so hot.
I...
Oh my goodness.
What have you told her?
I'm so proud.
What?
So proud.
What? She was just with Emily, for context.
Okay. Why, thank you. I'm a sly kind of guy. I've got charisma, all that jazz.
Okay.
He
thanks you and says that he's sly and has charisma.
You can tell. I don't know if you can still hear me, but it was Emily, Lauren, me, Megan, Toby, and their mom. And we all had a moment of silence and applauded for him.
Did you?
You applauded for a man who wasn't there?
Yes, we did. We all did.
Well, that's bizarre, but all right.
We're all very proud.
I don't know how I feel about that.
And very
but
nice, apparently.
He doesn't know how he feels about it.
That's okay. We're all very proud.
How does this happen? Is this like woman talk? Is this what happens?
Walked up to some goddess and was like, hey, can I have your number? It's really impressive.
I'm sorry for understating it, Rihanna.
Well, you really did.
I'm sorry.
You really did.
What?
I would have been terrified to do that. That's like if I went up to Chris Evans and was like, hey, yo, shot my shot. I don't think I could have done it.
Gosh. Okay.
What is she saying?
She's just talking about how impressed she is. She said that you didn't just walk up to any woman. You walked up to a goddess.
A goddess.
And you were bold and fearless. Nonetheless.
Dang.
She's saying that if she were a man, she would have been afraid to do it.
Hey, it was an incremental thing over the course of like 2 days.
He says it was incremental.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay. Baby steps. Like Bill
Murray. Baby steps. Yep.
I finished the deal and hopefully she comes to the adult group and has a good time.
Hopefully.
I think even Emily, the Bible study, Lily's coming.
All the girls. She's saying that all the girls are coming to Bible study.
Yeah.
Well, Micah, that's why I'm insisting on teaching. Because if she shows up, I don't want to fail you, man.
Yeah, she's like, what's all this? This is a joke.
Yeah, I'm not going to make it a joke. I'm not going to cancel or make it a game night. No, no, no. I'm going to do my best. It'll be a good one.
I like a kind of laxed but more conversational study sometimes, so. But
I know
it can be harder
do
with more people.
I know you do.
So.
I won't fail you, my son. It's gonna be a good week. Still have to write it, but you know.
I think the shot helped.
The
fireball.
Oh yeah, he's saying he thinks the fireball shot helped.
Liquid courage.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, probably did a little bit.
It probably did. No, no, no.
Here's some confidence booster.
You just had to believe in yourself, Micah. You just had to believe.
Believed.
Yeah, you just had to believe in yourself.
I'm a believer.
I believed in myself to not hit on anybody.
Did I tell you I got her number? Or were you there for that?
No, you didn't tell me that. We had left, remember? So you though. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Yep. He got the digits, Rihanna. He got the digits.
I know. It's crazy.
Jensen and I had left at that point.
I can't believe it.
Got the digits.
That's how I gave her the information for the adults grouping up. I was like, hey, I need to give you that information. So you need to give me your information.
That's true. She was nice. She was practically a stranger, but she went back to the church to help us out. I mean, she was the only...
She was a trooper.
Yeah. She was the only non-family or close friend to come back and help us, so... Yeah.
Hopefully she will become in the fold of women and not feel alienated. I'll try to help her.
She's a Nigerian, you say? Yes. Oh man, Micah, if you marry her, you'll get the N-word pass.
I thought isn't she from Ethiopia, though? Or is that the same place?
Isn't she a little dark to be Ethiopian?
Well,
I don't know. Maybe Rihanna misheard. Maybe she is Ethiopian.
Whatever the case is, I will forever be given the pass.
True.
She's going to have to be okay with me being racist against all races. So that bridge will have to be crossed.
As long as you're fair and you're equal to all.
Yes, I'm equally racist to all races.
And with that message, we're going to end the stream there.
Yeah.
Micah is equal to all races, so you can't.
Exactly.
You can't bag it, man. Oh, we got a comment from Vito Grubik. He posed simply a question mark. That's all right if you're confused, Vito. We are too.
Yes.
And we're not going to explain that one.